Well, Southern California has been soaked by a lot of heavy rain lately, but now some scientists wonder if all that rain could stress our earthquake faults and trigger a devastating quake. Well, research shows there may be a link between rain and earthquakes.
But there is debate tonight over this because some other scientists, well, they don't buy it. KCAL9'S Andrea Fujii is live at the Eaton Canyon Reservoir in Pasadena tonight. Andrea, what is this all about, this study?
Well, Jeff and Susie, water levels have risen in many reservoirs, including this one behind me. But a new study says all that water may trigger an earthquake, but not all experts agree. Southern California has reaped many benefits from the recent rain, but a report from phys.org suggests California could be in for some earthquakes as rain seeps deep into the faults and our reservoirs and aquifers, once empty, now filled with heavy water. The report says the pressure underground could trigger the tremors.
It's a bit scary.
But Dr. Lucy Jones from Caltech says the study cites shallow earthquakes that happened after heavy rainfall 15 years ago in Germany and Switzerland.
It did in Europe. We've never seen it here.
And she says to trigger an earthquake here of any significant magnitude, the water would have to go about 6 miles below the surface.
Even if you add a lot, 20 feet, it's such a small percentage compared to that 4 kilometers of weight that matters down at the bottom.
Still, people we talked with say any prospect of earthquakes is frightening.
Eerily anticipating one, but who knows? We needed the rain.
The report cited 170 reservoirs around the world that have had induced quake activity. But Dr. Jones says though rain can wreak all kinds of havoc, earthquakes are likely not one of them.
Failing dams, landslides, the actual damage that rain does to California exceeds what the earthquakes have.
And Dr. Jones says we can try to predict earthquakes as much as we want, but the reality is they can happen at any time. Jeff and Susie, back to you.
Andrea, thank you so much.